We're gonna pop into this room. It's always my favorite room. I love the power rooms. This is all electrical switchgear, all in a big lineup. This is our paralleling system for several of the generators. This is our utility side service. You can see some of our very large cables coming in here. This is going over to feed the automatic transfer switches. And then as we go through here, this is our transformer aisle. As you can see, these are all red tags, so these are all on generator backup. You get over to the DC power section, and you can see our 3000 amp DC power disconnects. These actually are what the equipment runs on, using these large power cables. And here's batteries. These batteries run part of this floor, and there's a lot of them. These buses on the top here are probably the most amazing part. Those are live. Those are carrying 48 volt DC, which is a pretty low voltage. You can touch them as long as your hands aren't too wet. You won't feel it. But if you short between those, you will get a gigantic explosion. These are what carry the emergency power and primary power that run all of our equipment. This battery system is so big that it can run this site for about 4.5 hours without the generators. There's another battery system like this on the other side of this floor and another one a couple floors down. So this site has quite a robust power system. So this is another battery string. This battery string is really guarded with our signage. And the reason it's guarded is because this is a 400 volt battery string. These run our UPS system. This site has both 48 volt DC for backup power, but it also has backed up 480 volt AC. And to back that up, you have to have a similar voltage of DC to feed the UPS, which is in the next room and I'll show you. This site has three UPSs like this. This one covers the AC powered loads on this floor, the floor above, and a corporate data center we have on the third floor. So at this site, for all of our critical AC power, that means everything south of the generator systems or south of UPSs, we use cable and tray. This is 480 volt cables running in a tray. This is only allowed in a controlled environment because the cable is physically subject to damage. But the reason we use it is it's got a very low failure rate per foot. It allows us to operate with a very high reliability, but without the failures that you see with bus duct or with often cable and conduit where it gets scuffed. This allows us to visually inspect the cable, which we do on an annual basis with infrared cameras, and allows us to overlay more cables as needed. You can see those routing both to the input and output of the UPS here. So I wanted to bring you up to the roof today to kind of show off how big this operation is and how much infrastructure it takes to provide the services we provide. This building is one of my personal favorite central offices because it has a glorious view of the mountains. But more importantly, it also shows how much infrastructure we have at our offices, and we have about 200 of these buildings that are required to deliver that service you use every day at home. So I'm gonna take you over and see some of the air conditioners here. So most of our sites use Liebert or Emerson network power cooling. This site's no exception. As you can see today, none of these are actually running, and they're not running because it's cold out. So on these cold days, we utilize outside air economization, and you can see buildings like this one that we're walking up to right here have fans in them. They suck air from the outside to the inside. And today, if I walk over here, it's about 75 degrees right here. And that's because this is air coming up from downstairs in our technical operations areas, but not using air conditioning. And that helps us offer a greener footprint for our data centers and the infrastructure that's required to provide service to folks' houses and businesses while doing that in the most efficient way possible. Okay, we're gonna go into our generator room here. This is how we keep the lights on. Anytime the power goes out, this site has about 10,000 gallons of fuel storage and has four of these generators. So two here on the roof and two are in the parking lot in the back. We do that for redundancy so that we can carry the site with a very small number of them running. Most of the time throughout the year, this site would only require one generator. In the summer, it requires two out of the four to be working to carry the site. So that's part of our defense in depth to outages and how we keep the service running even when something fails. We don't share battery strings or anything across generators. They all have to fail independently because generators can and do fail, which is why there are always multiple generators available at our important sites.